I guess it's official now. Settled on my house. Picked up the keys from Norton Realty. Time to go in and go through it as my own house. So weird. I don't actually even know which key. Must be one of these ones. Let's give it a go. So much work to do, but it's going to be worth it, like so worth it in the end. Like, I'll do some before and after shots and during in this video. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoy the process as much as I'm going to. I'm so excited, I can't wait to start. I want someone to love.
So to start the video, I just wanted to give a rundown of the house and everything that needed to be done.
Oh no!
As you can already see from the front entrance, stone house needed a fair bit of work done.
I've locked myself out!
Hi, how are you? As you walk in, you have the hall with two bedrooms. Carpets are stained, stickers, sticky tape, you name it, it was on the wall.
Beautiful dolphin curtain.
This bedroom was the only room where the mantelpiece hadn't been damaged in some way or had the fire used as an open fire. Bedroom 2 was a little bit more worse for wear. It had marks all over the walls as well, but the skirts were chipped. There were damp issues, cracks everywhere. Fireplace was absolutely disgusting. It was like someone had cooked something in it and it smelled like it had been urinated in a few times. Moving on into the lounge room now, it was quite basic, but oh my god, the carpet reeked of cat wee. Like it was horrible and there was fur everywhere. Next we have the kitchen, which needed a fair bit done. This corner over here was really badly affected by the rising damp, which we'll explain why later. Paint was peeling like mad, but again, this was due to the moisture issues. Next we have what we called the lobby, which comes off the lounge room into the newer section of the house. One of the many mice we saw. There was a toilet with a cracked bowl, dust and spiderweb infested windows, and a shower which had lost some tiles but didn't seem to be an issue because black plastic is a good replacement for tiles apparently. Off the lobby, there was a kitchenette which wasn't too bad apart from a few broken and misplaced tiles and an outdated cabinet. Apparently this newer section of the house was used by a previous owner many years ago and he rented out the main part of the house. I'm not really sure why, but at some point someone decided to put this horrible cheese looking filler in like near the ceiling and wall where it joins. Looks like a heap of cheese. Through the kitchenette we have another bedroom or sleep out, whatever you want to call it, and pretty much every panel of glass had been smashed in. At the back of the house, off the lounge room, there was another room, potentially a rumpus or something, with a bathroom and laundry off the side. But the bathroom was terrible, like full of bugs, stunk of mold, and had another dead mouse which obviously had been there for a bit longer than the other one I just showed you, and the plumbing was, well, more plastic there for you, very exposed. Last room in the house was the laundry, very dark and dingy with a toilet full of shit.
What you spraying?
Didn't take us long to get started on the renos, with the removal of the cat urine stained carpets being job number one on the list.
Baby girl, you give me tension of fatness, give me some of that. Thinks with the badness, look how she at. Shape like a dead person, just that. It's a good piece of mental sand that they camp. A piece of game, I'm in love how you chat. Watching every step of the paper, the way you got. Staying in my brain, memory not detached. Mainly my aim is to give you this love, hypnotic. The way you move, let me acknowledge the way you do. Then I would not lie, baby, you be me a black daddy. It's how hypnotic the way you move. It's why I wanted to dance with you. And I would not lie, like baby, you moves how hypnotic.
No lie,
girl, you never miss.
I feel your eyes, they all over me. Don't be shy, take control of me. It's the vibe that's gonna be lit tonight.
Girl, you never miss.
No lie,
girl, you never miss.
Hypnotized, pull another one. It's alright, I know what you want.
Reno dog number one. Reno dog number two. So what have you got on you? Spiderweb dog. Oh, Nini, let's get that off. Today we're going to do some demolition and start pulling the walls out and getting it all prepped for the builders and tilers and everyone to come in to redo it all and make it nice.
Had cement rented walls, the whole house basically had a heap of cracks throughout it that had developed over time just from a little bit of movement, so we decided to dig them out properly, fill them in, and have Ando come in to do the last few coats for a smooth finish.
What did you just say?
I said it looks like someone smashed a finger bun up there.
The pencil is out.
I don't even know what that looks like.
Cheese on the ceiling. Look at the dust coming up off the ground. It's not mine. Oh my god, are you dumb?
What are you doing?
Get
out of here.
Okay, open the window, let some fresh air in.
Cause I'm lost in the way you move, the way you feel. Is all it takes, falling in love with me. Possibilities, I look like all you need. One kiss is all it takes, falling in love with me. Possibilities, I look like all you need.
Block my ears with both hands.
What was that?
So unfortunately the framework in the bathroom and laundry had rotted and pretty well needed to be fully replaced. And Slater came in and did the works and so many other parts of the house throughout the process.
This is going to be the bathroom. I'll come in the door here. There'll be a vanity here. The shower will be in the same spot as it was before. We've got our little niche there, nice big one. And we've got a window there, and there'll be a panel of glass between there and the vanity. You walk around here into the shower. You look worried.
No, I'm just looking.
All nice.
And with all the old framework removed, we ended up with a huge pile of wood out the back.
Today, we get rid of the rubbish. Had so much rain and it's just not going away. It's been getting worse, actually. I have to get the gutters redone because they're not angled the right way. They're pooling and then the water's overflowing. The gutter out the front is like stained from like just so much time of water sitting there. There you go, you can see that. Look at that. So we have a guy coming to fix that, which will be good. That means that, you know, the water won't be just like overflowing and sitting in the garden and stuff. But this is what we're going to try and fix today. We're getting the tractor in to re-level slope instead of the driveway. You can't really tell, but there's a slight slope that comes back to the house. So we're going to try and slope it the other way so the water drains away from the house. And like, look, it's like up to the window.
So I originally said with confidence that I would never be getting rid of this beautiful garden, but that took a turn once we realised that one of the main contributors of the moisture issues in the corner of the kitchen was the garden. An old terracotta pipe which led to the well had been cracked by the roots, so all the rainwater would go into the soil and then soak up the wall. The tractor work and removing the garden did the trick though, and after a few months of these changes and some crete sealing, the walls dried up and we were ready to sand and paint. Jacob Hardy also came in and he had done all the plaster work and did a fantastic job on the cornicing. I'm
god. Oh my god, that looks so f***ing good. Rebecca's getting her cleaning fix. How do you feel?
My arm's sore.
Tell the camera.
I don't
want to. Oh my god.
Laura!
It's just going to be a compilation at the end of you going, Laura, get away!
It's like that. What's her name?
Brianna!
Oh, it's here. Oh my god.
Just dust on it from
the It's alright though, it looks good. Oh.
I was worried about it.
Let's get it inside! Bad.
This is what it looked like beforehand, but thanks to Not Too Shabby, it was turned into a really beautiful piece.
Just
is it on for now?
Yeah. I don't know what the that is.
Are you just going to put it where the bath is? Going? Just so it's just there?
Oh my god, that looks so good. So I seat you around that way. There, we good.
God, look at those camera skills.
Press stop. I don't know how to.
Press stop. You press stop, camera wall.
What is on it?
So last weekend we finished all the painting. I was a little bit hungover, didn't want to be there. We were just pumping it out, trying to get it done as quick as we could because we knew the floorboards were getting done. Anyway, we finished at like 20 to 11 and I was just like dead. Yeah, we definitely had to get it done before this was done because we don't want to put paint splats all over the new floor, which looks... Oh my god, I'm just so happy with it. God. So we finished the painting and then we had to move all the shit that we had lying around everywhere inside into this back room because there's this one little section of cement, which I still don't know what we're going to do with that. Probably just... Might just paint it for now or something, but in the future I'd love to tile it like the bathroom and laundry tiles. So anyway, we moved all this shit into here. We had our scaffolding and everything that we had to move as well, and stools and random shit, which we've all put out the back as well. We've got our lovely rubbish pile at the moment. That's got to go soon. Dad's getting the excavator again today, and he's digging another trench for drainage, plumbing. Because previously it was all above ground. The previous owners had it just running along the top of the grass. We've actually got, you'll be able to see here, I zoomed down the back. That's all of it there. So it came from like, it was a downpipe there, which we've got to reconnect. It went all the way along there. So you can see it there on the fence line, all the way down and out. So now Dad's going to add to this trench and dig where the downpipe would go to the back where it went along the top of the grass. So it won't be seen, which will be great.
So for a little bit of context, basically a pipe burst that was really old. So we came in with the excavator to dig it out to save a bit of money, and Schoies Plumbing came in and replaced it all for us.
So yeah, I guess we'll get started into our day. I'll start with some sanding. Dad'll be here soon with the excavator, he'll start digging. Gonna dig some of the front yard up too, dig it down a foot and level it out, make it nice. It's gonna be a full on day. I think it's like 39 degrees or something today. I'm already sweating and it's only 20 to 10 in the morning, so let's see how we go. Please forgive me for the mess I made. Please forgive me, promise I'll change. finished painting everything, and then this bitch. What do you think we need to do now?
Well, you're gonna paint this.
You have to paint this all the way around.
I was so sick of painting walls at this stage, and was just gonna leave the cement rendered wall how it was, but Laura ended up convincing me otherwise. Massive thanks to my Uncle Jimmy for teaching me how not to electrocute myself and rewiring a fair chunk of the electrical in the house for me. I learnt so much along the way. Thanks, Jimmy.
Simple job and look. Look at this. What do you have to can say for yourself?
Move your fingers, Dad, because they're going
to
be in the frame.
Yeah, no, I've filmed before. Just let me do my job, Laura. You worry about that step. Doing the deck. Laura loves playing around with the deck.
Do. It's my
favourite pastime.
Always wanted a
dick.
Decks and logs.
I'm gonna have to turn the audio
up
on this one.
Doing a good job. One thing that I completely forgot to film was the process of the kitchen. Jody from JMH did an awesome job designing and setting out the kitchen and also scribing it in to fit the old warped walls. There was a crack in the kitchen though, but nothing a bit of spack filler couldn't fix. I also forgot to mention Appsy for his help with restoring all the windows and fitting the shower screens. When I look back at the history of this house with its many cats and how it was then to how it was now, I just can't help but think of what an amazing transformation we have completed. Like, we've taken this house from decrepit and filthy and turned it into something really beautiful. I'm proud to say that I absolutely love my house and the journey we went on in changing it from this to this.
Yeah, that sounds good.